way.
Look, when you fill my drink.
I'll be
Is it Mad Dog here?
Say, mister, are you one of them badass rock stars?
Oh, Jen, you scared the crap out of me.
Sorry, babe. Hey, Lewis, what's up?
This huge freak in the crowd kept staring at me like some whacked out psycho.
Well, maybe you never checked out your audience before, but you guys don't exactly share the same fan base as Kenny G.
Oh, this was different. He looks seriously creepy.
Ooh, that reminds me. Grab your money and let's split. We gotta go visit the landlord.
Great set, man.
Come on. If we don't pay him tonight, we're gonna be living in a box.
Ah, Jen. You never used to complain. I think we're going to party.
I'm 21 now, Lewis. Too old to be living like a bum. Plus, I'm gonna need study space once I start college. No autographs, creep.
Good night, guys. See you next time.
See you, buddy.
God, what is that thing?
Hey! Don't make me hurt you, man.
Is this your Jane Doe?
Yeah. Came in 2 nights ago. Hasn't come round yet. She's a fighter, though. I've lost plenty with injuries less than hers.
5 broken ribs, lung punctured in 2 places, ruptured spleen. What'd you do, get hit by a truck?
Yeah, she left some nightclub with her boyfriend. Looks like a gang jumped them. Left her lying outside the club. They found him several blocks away. He's in the room 3 doors down.
So, what do you think?
50-50.
Come on, Doctor. There's a coffee and donut downstairs. Need your attention.
That was one freaky dream. This a hospital? What the hell happened? Oh my God. I'm dead? No, I don't want to be dead. Things were just starting to work out. Lewis and I were just... Oh my God. Lewis, what happened to us? Huh? What the hell are you? A bit short for the Grim Reaper, aren't you?
You're not dead, Jennifer, but if you don't be quiet and listen to me, you soon will be. My name is, well, let's say you can call me Scree. I've been sent to find you, to show you some very important things, and to enlist your assistance.
Right. Well, Scree, glad I'm not dead, but first you better explain how come I'm looking down on myself. She is creeping me out.
Your corporeal form, the one still lying there, is very weak, close to death perhaps, but not yet lost. That is only part of you. The other part, your spirit. That's you. I set it free from your body so that we could talk. In fact, now that it's free, you'll find you can travel to places you've never even imagined.
Right, so I'm like an astral projection or something?
Essentially, yes.
So what does that make you?
I am but a humble servant to my lady, and to you I'm a friend, someone you need to trust. Now quickly, you must come with me. We're both vulnerable here.
Okay, but only because I'm intrigued. I've never been in astral projection before.
Okay, Jennifer.
What the hell? My God. What just happened? Where are we?
Questions. We're no longer immortalis. We've stepped through a rift gate into the Nexus.
Still, huh?
As I said earlier, your spirit is no longer constrained by flesh. You have left the physical mortal world and now stand in the Nexus, a convergence point for energies drawn from the four realms of Oblivion.
Sounds like one of Lewis's fantasy novels.
This is real, Jennifer. I know you mortals think you're at the heart of everything, but believe me, you're not. Now please try to absorb all of this quickly. There really is no time to waste.
Okay, I'm trying. Just one thing, though. No matter where we are, you gotta stop calling me Jennifer. You sound like my stepdad. It's Jen.
I am to give you these. They are devices that will help you to learn of your true self. And if my lady is correct, they may afford us some protection.
What am I supposed to do with this?
It's a vambrace. They fasten around your wrists. Please, it's important that you trust me and just put them on.
I've just jumped out of my skin, left my body in some hospital, been dragged through a rift gate.
Rift gate?
And I'm in Oblivion. Vambrace? Not a problem.
Precisely.
Ooh, shiny. And pretty comfy for a pair of metal doodads. Could have been made for me.
They were.
So, how do I get them off?
You don't.
And this guy wants me to trust him. This lady you keep mentioning, who is she?
I serve Arella. She is all that is good and pure. She is strength and virtue. She is righteousness. She is nobility.
She's a person, right?
She is not a person. She is not mere flesh and bone, emotion and desire. She is one of two primal forces that govern the universe. She is order.
And the other would be?
The other would be Abaddon, the embodiment of chaos, lord of corruption and decay. He is my lady's eternal foe and the reason for my being.
Right. You know you're gonna have to introduce me to this Arella.
Oh, I shall, and she will be most relieved to see you. But first, I must show you more of Oblivion. Please follow me.
Scree, will all this start making sense anytime soon? Is there nothing you can say that won't leave my head spinning?
I think that perhaps your Lewis may have been brought here.
Lewis? Lewis here? You've got to help me find him. So, they got one of these.
With the might of chaos and order eternally battling, a balance between them must also be fought for. Here at the heart of the Nexus is where that happens. Drawing in the two primal forces, governing, generating a safe parallel energy, that is the awesome responsibility of Kronos.
And awesome's the word for this gadget. Oh, there's someone in the middle of all that.
As I said, Jen, Kronos.
Jeez, he's looking at me.
Perhaps he can hear you, too.
Well... I'm sure the guy's doing a great job in there. On there. God, Scree, he's plugged into the damn thing.
It is an ancient machine, with Kronos living at its heart. There are four realms in Oblivion, Jen. Two aligned with order and two with chaos. Each realm has its own natural balance, eternally generating the right levels of primal energy, which is drawn into the Nexus and fed through Kronos to Arella and Abaddon. Kronos has eternally governed with wisdom and impartiality, channeling balanced strength to them both. Without him, the Nexus, Oblivion, and your Mortalis wouldn't exist at all. Simple as that.
You know, if I was as wise as this Kronos, I'd find a cushier job. Pull out the jacks and swing in the hammock for a while.
For all our sakes, I trust your own sense of responsibility matches your distinctive sense of humor.
Distinctive good or distinctive?
Distinctive inappropriate.
Jeez, I'm being heckled by a troll. Is he okay? That doesn't look too healthy.
No. The force of chaos is overpowering him. Abaddon is putting his ancient plan into practice. A break with eternity. He's secretly corrupting the kingdoms of order, strengthening the realms of chaos, foolishly rocking the Nexus like a boat about to capsize. Just look at our guardian suffering to keep control. He may not last very long. Come on, Jen. We have no time to lose.
Okay. I'm coming. Just don't leave me behind here. It's no good. I'm gonna have to ask Scree.
Questions again. And if there's something I'd want you to ask, you never do. What, please?
These symbols.
Ah.
I presume you have noticed this.
Indeed, there is a remarkable similarity.
They are identical, you lunk. Lewis drew the design for me just after we met. How come the symbols all over the place here?
I simply can't tell you.
Can't or won't?
It's branded on you, Jen, not me. I don't know everything.
It's not branded, it's just a tattoo, goddammit. Lewis told me it was a ancient rune of protection. I just thought it looked cool.
Where did Lewis see this symbol? It's very important.
He wouldn't tell me. Oh, forget it. Everything else going on, that ain't gonna freak me out. Come on, little guy. Where are we now?
We have entered the kingdom of Solom. Time stands still in the four realms connected to the Nexus. In this realm, it is eternal night.
And let me guess. Eternal winter?
By nature, Solom is bleak of climate, but nothing too harsh for its people. The Ferai are strong and resourceful hunters.
You say hunters?
The worlds of Oblivion are each inhabited by a different race, and yes, the Ferai are fierce, sometimes brutal, but they are fundamentally good. You're going to meet a lot worse, I assure you.
Splendid.
Solom and its people have always been aligned with order, providing my Lady Arella with power.
But now things have gotten screwed up, right?
Yes, thanks to Abaddon's villainy. His interference in the realms is drawing all the primal energy to his side and starving my lady of her very existence. In truth, neither side can survive without the other, and soon everything will be destroyed.
So the guy's trashing the status quo, creating chaos. Guess he's doing his job.
And we must do ours, so just listen.
Oops.
I'm sorry. You must forgive me for that, Jen. So much more will become clear to you, child, but we've so little time.
Hey, look, don't sweat it. I'm fine. So what's to be done here? Let's get on with it.
Thank you, Jen. Right, now, what we've got to do here, Jen, is... I haven't the faintest idea. But I do know Solom has been tainted by chaos somehow, and we have to restore the natural order. I told you the Ferai are violent, but they live as a basically peaceful clan with rituals and art, for example. A structured society. The one crucial thing for the race is their king. In Solom, the king has huge authority, awesome strength, but he must, without fail, sacrifice himself at the height of his power and pass the throne to his heir.
Gruesome.
Ah, yes, the burning crown, the traditional method of royal sacrifice. Failure of the king to abdicate his power would devastate the land and lead its people to ruin.
Ruin as in...
Precisely. The king here is Hearn, strong, deadly even, but always a good leader for his people, I believe. A Ferai king like any other through eternity. But some time ago, he was due to relinquish power.
And he's running for another term.
He is senselessly refusing to give up his rule, and so leading the Ferai to disaster.
So we check it out. Cool.
Yes. A sound plan of action.
You hear those growls, Scree?
That sounds like Malkai. They're primitive, territorial beasts. Huge teeth, fearsome claws, fond of the dark.
Well, that's it. We ain't moving. Oh, no.
I suspect they'd only be interested in devouring you.
Oh, great.
I doubt they'd find me too palatable.
Sure. They don't look particularly tasty.
Malkai are afraid of fire. I'll scout ahead, see if I can find anything. I've illuminated the cave, Jen. It should be safe for you to enter.
Small point. Typical picky me. Should be safe or is safe?
It is safe.
Well done, big guy.
You know, being small and made from stone has some advantages.
It does?
Absolutely. I can climb up any stonework surface. Now that's something that might be useful to us, don't you think?
I guess.
In.
Uh-oh.
Don't panic. They can smell fear, you know.
You're not on the menu here. I'll smell how I want.
Shit.
corner, Lady. Quip ali dini apergili.
Turn. Don't worry. I can speak the demon tongue.
Deus Safinta, Dwend em Gen, Eb em Ota Jimen Diarella, Eb Hiven Keferai, Ekta Sansetem Rekba.
This runt would have me believe you're an envoy of the goddess Arella. You look more like a sniveling half-breed to me.
Scree, I vote we're big enough to swallow the odd insult here.
Strangers, in these treacherous times, should I drive you from my kingdom or leave you to the Maokai?
Trust me, Lord Hearn. We're here to help you.
Help me? I suppose you must know the whereabouts of my son, then.
Well, no.
Then you are of no use. It was a night like this when Jared went missing.
But listen, I do know what it's like to lose someone. My friend Lewis was taken from me. Couldn't we at least help you look for Jared?
You seem ill-equipped to be helping anyone. Take this, and you may just survive the night.
Thanks.
I have no more time for strangers. I must return to the great temple. Perhaps tonight my prayers will be answered.
I guess we know what he prays for.
The safe return of his son.
Come on, Scree. We can do it. Let's find this Jared.
Fine, fine, as you wish. I'll add him to the list.
Hey, why do you call me a half-breed?
Perhaps...
So many earthquakes.
The land suffers as a result of Hearn's poor judgment. Several moons have passed since he failed to relinquish his throne.
He didn't fail, Scree. How can he let go when there's no heir to take over?
Of course. Finding Jared could be the key to restoring the balance in Solon. We should ask these tribesmen if they know anything about Jared's disappearance.
Shoot.
Beagni, Nedi Vasus Agap the Keep Gaxi Kodvol Vek Jared?
Anot bot kapki. Ob non gyanol ruledon, vumila bab ot vern klumpad. Ob sa kernast Jared nukti.
Apparently, Jared used to hunt here. Some time ago, the locals heard a terrible fight raging. Nobody's seen him since. Now, this isn't a good sign.
What is it?
It's a piece of a ferai's horn. It has an engraved tip. The symbol is similar to one used by Hearn's family.
I guess we should show it to him then. Get down, someone's coming. This does not look like a welcoming committee.
Casus dies is includi vit deos jaluenari.
Di job tu penny, barduli alheg diden, dur san jib mob vedum bolhen, deos nid ju bub caverbe.
Tupid! Du lasso san pen, ati san apa.
Divina is known as a noble and just queen. Why would she have someone murdered like that?
Guess she ain't the gal she used to be.
The prisoner was no criminal. He was a shaman, a Ferai holy man. He spoke of uncovering Divina's secret and that there were others still loyal to Hearn. We must find out what he meant.
Wonder if Hearn knows about his wife's mean streak.
I doubt it, and I don't relish the task of telling him.
Scree, what's with the glowing stuff?
It happens when I'm close to stone figures resonating with Ferai energy. It means I can temporarily transfer my soul into any statue formed from this material.
Cool.
Cool? Just wait till you see me do it. Then you'll see what I'm made of. Cool.
Okay. Go ahead, that's a fine statue, a lovely glow.
I can't do it yet. I need the essence from more Ferai lodestones before I can shift form.
Okay, calm down. I'll take your word for it. Rocky.
If only she knew.
Apinag, Sanbinan Huvnilak, Trasus Eni Inonak, Apinagdi, Trasus Eni Inonak, Apinagdi, Trasus Eni Inonak, Apinagdi, Apinag, Sanbinan Huvnilak, Trasus Eni Inonak, Apinagdi, Apinagdi, Trasus Eni Inonak, Apinagdi, Apinagdi, Trasus Eni Inonak, Apinagdi, Apinagdi, Apinag, Sanbinan Huvnilak, Trasus Eni Inonak, Apinagdi, Apinagdi, Trasus Eni Inonak, Apinagdi,
found this.
Apinagdi. Quip Sanbinan!
You!
Why do you interrupt my ritual? What is this? What have you found?
This is Jared's. Where did you find it?
It was lying in an old ruin. There was blood and signs of a battle, and corpses.
My son?
No. Three huntsmen had fallen in combat, but this was the only sign of Jared.
I must discover my son's fate and find those who have wronged him.
Lord Hearn, how is Lady Divina coping with your son's disappearance?
My wife keeps her own counsel these days.
Well, the last time we saw her... What the...
Have the gods on...
But doim em gasus hoc eog jana bin an shedi vode da od bol vof chabakumid, henda vit van sep hup shakri pavilin in baan ikoyos kak. Ot naka, pijade eos piam gili em velimin vapapot an ogin. Vonod lirak ol eos hani. Lin really eos va bolgalcitas, lin really eos trapolin, lin really eos binan bolsidi, lin really eos va bolgalcitas, lin really eos trapolin, lin really eos binan bolsidi. Two arca.
Sorry to interrupt you there.
Velboft eoso trilacrun.
No further! Do they know they approach the sacred grounds? Doubtless you are right.
We saw your fire, that's all.
We're kinda asking everyone. Have you seen Prince Jared? We're trying to find him.
Spin it! A spirit walking with... Well, why don't you ask him?
I guess you haven't seen him then, huh?
Nobody approaches the sacred necropolis. Even princes, be warned. Keep away.
We must travel no further. The necropolis is sacred to the Ferae.
Scree. Duh! Jared's vanished. Of course he'd never be seen in a place where nobody ever goes. We've got to check it out. Listen up. I'm sorry, but there's something you need to know.
She will speak.
That sacred place of yours isn't quite so off limits as you think. It's crawling with people.
Jen, allow me to handle this. Sir, the necropolis, we have evidence of Ferae presence there. Guards, archers.
That's what I said.
You have dared to set your dirty feet there?
My companion here lost her bearings and...
The point is, they are there. You know about that? What are they doing?
It is a sacrilege!
I'd say they're there for a purpose. They're using the cover of sacred land, guarded by yourself here, warning people off as a hideaway. And the one who is hidden is Jared.
Stop! Now, continue.
Sir, the only path to sanctity, the kingdom's survival, is for Jared to be found. And then Hearn will be able to relinquish his throne. We need to explore the necropolis.
No one passes this...
We're asking your blessing.
Meanwhile, there are soldiers stamping all over that hallowed place.
Stamping with their dirty feet.
Yes, and we're willing to get them out of there.
No more. You have my blessing. In these accursed days, we look beyond our first desires. Well, for the spirit. If you are to enter the necropolis, you will need this.
Hey there.
Jared, is that you?
What have they done to him?
Your father has been wild with despair.
My father...
Take it easy. Come on, let me get these chains off you.
What happened to you?
On a hunt some moons ago, I was attacked by that fiend who sits at my father's right hand.
Who do you mean?
Captured. Tortured. Chained here ever since. forced to listen as she came back and told me of each new act of wickedness she'd inflicted on my people. Each trick she played to inflame my father's misery.
What? Wait up. Davina did this to you? Your own mother?
No! Not my mother! That thing that calls itself Davina, that lies down with my father set on choking up my bloodline, bringing this realm to its knees. That thing is an imposter, a shape-shifter, not born of this land.
Highness, how can you be so sure when even your father, the king, suspects nothing?
She couldn't resist telling me. Smiled and said my mother lay in a chamber nearby. This imposter often goes there. I've heard chanting. Terrible noises.
Well, let's go and see if we can get in there then.
She's no fool. It'll be locked.
Ah, fine. I was only...
And the key, Highness?
If it's anywhere, the key may be in her rooms at my father's fortress. Yes. She suddenly took to keeping her rooms heavily guarded just before I was abducted. Now if we... You must help me. This imposter must be revealed. If I only had strength, we have to...
Save your strength, Highness. It is best that no one knows that we have discovered you here. Rest now while we find this key.
Yeah, and make him think I haven't untied you.
My friend, I am truly grateful for your help. I can sense your strength, even if you do not have a look of a warrior.
You wouldn't say that if you'd seen her earlier.
Okay then, Scree. Let's head for the fortress.
Please, take this talisman. It will prove your worth to my countrymen.
We will return.
Looks like you found an admirer.
Button it, Scree. We got a fortress to raid. We'll show him the talisman Jared gave us.
Gili inopiab, ubgasa duen.
Hijiwa piab.
Lukaskon. Spectacular. Davina had always been opposed to the practice, and it was no surprise when it was outlawed after Hearn became High King.
Ooh, spooky. That statue reminds me of you somehow.
Ah, well, that's Abdizur. It's interesting that you mention it because...
Except he looks like a fearsome, impressive creature, and you, well, you're you.
Yes, well, as you say.
Abaddon.
The runes are cast. Abdizur is lost. Why fight me, daughter?
You! What have you done with Lewis?
Run! You've seen Belazur's strength! Quickly then, hide!
Thank you.
corkscrew.
Now that took me back.
That was the thing that jumped me and Lewis at the club. What was it?
That's Belazur, a demon of chaos. Abaddon's most lethal killer. Where he travels, pain and suffering will surely follow.
You seem to handle him quite well.
The mighty form of Abdazur was thankfully at hand. Abdazur and Belazur have fought many titanic battles.
Yeah? Well, you and the big man made a great team. Don't you think so, Rocky boy?
Belazur is far from destroyed. I merely bought us some time.
The face in the smoke. It was talking to me, wasn't it?
You saw a shade of Abaddon.
He called me daughter.
And then he sent a monster to kill you. Abaddon is chaos, Jen. Don't let him wreak havoc in your mind.
I want Lewis Scree. I need Lewis to be here.
Right. We are both thinking too much, and both feeling sorry for ourselves. All we need to think about, my girl, is a way out of this arena.
Isake panukakabe apkyun salizni santaist. Miss Bavin, alixit hir vier agli. Bakin! Bakin!
Jen, we should expect company.
If you're looking for the king, I think he has other things on his mind.
Like trying to figure out what you've done with your...
Well, hang on now, Jen. Let's not set off on the wrong foot.
Back in!
Check this out. One of these must be the key we're after.
Excellent. Let's get straight back to Jared.
Do you have the key?
Yes, it was in the Queen's chambers, just as you said.
Thank you.
Permit me to go first, Highness. Who knows what we may find?
My mother is in there. I have nothing to fear.
First, we must unmask the imposter. Do you know any way to break the enchantment?
I don't know. The creature has retained my mother's form, while these remains have stayed free from corruption. There is some dark necromancy at work here. Those chants I heard came from this chamber.
Fire.
What?
The spell must be broken. With your permission, Highness, we should cremate the body.
Let it be done. Mother, how did this befall us?
done.
What now?
Now, I will have my revenge.
Ah, the hex is broken. But you are too late to save your kingdom.
Not too late to tear your head off.
That too, boy. My final act as Divina was to order her most loyal guards to this chamber, expressly to kill you, their broken prince, along with this feeble mortal and her scuttling stone. Death. Right on time.
No! You've been deceived!
Stop! All of you!
My lord.
Silence!
My beloved boy. Silence! Guards, take up your arms. Serve your king, and see that this dissembling hag does not move. Jared, alive. My prayers are answered.
I let you down, father. If I had not been captured, none of these terrible...
You have changed, Jared. But I have been nothing but blind. A sovereign fool. Now you must be forever vigilant. Fight with your mind as well as your sword. And know that your mother and I are always with you.
I have much to tell you. We had no choice but to cremate my mother.
Enough! The ritual of succession has been delayed all too long. Now that you are safe, our kingdom can be strong once more. Only one task remains.
Forget you.
Who is that with Belazor?
I was too far away to see clearly. It could have been anyone.
You recognized Belazor, right?
Well, of course I did, but you mortals all look the same to me.
Mortal? What, it was a human?
Not exactly. The reach of chaos is long, and its demons take many forms. It must have been another of Abaddon's servants. Come on, we must return to the Nexus.
You're holding out on me.
There's no time for this. Abaddon's forces are in motion.
Abaddon, Arella, big deal. None of this has anything to do with me, Scree. I just want to find my boyfriend and go home.
Scree is not your enemy, Jennifer. I sent him to guide and protect you.
You're Arella? Butterflies. That's not what I was expecting.
I am in all things, and I appear in many forms. I understand your frustration, but you must realize that our goals are one and the same.
I doubt that.
It's true. I wish to see you safely return to your home, but...
Why? Why am I being roped into some turf war you're having with Abaddon, then? The way I see it, this is a personal problem. Yours.
Jennifer, if Abaddon gets his way, there will be no Mortalis for you to return to. At least not one you would recognize. For eternity, we have existed here in the Nexus. He and I, the one balancing the other so that all can flourish. Without him, there would be no change, no decay. Life in the realms would stagnate. But without my presence, all would descend into the mindless frenzy of chaos. Both sides are needed for harmony. Darkness and light. Chaos and order. A balanced unity. But Abaddon has become obsessed with power. He would see me destroyed, my influence lost, no matter the consequence. What happened in Solum was just the beginning. He will not rest until he has corrupted all the realms, yours included, and become the sole primal force.
This is all making me dizzy. I'm just a coffee shop waitress. Don't you need some kind of superhero helping you out here?
Come now. You have seen the power within yourself. Now unlocked, this will continue to grow. Your part in these events was sealed when you were but a baby. Journey to Aquis, and you will see more of the damage wrought by Abaddon's madness.
Okay, okay. I'll go.
Continue to guide her, loyal Abdazur. She will need your strength when her full self is revealed.
She is a wild creature, but I believe her heart is good.
Hey, now this is more like it. It's beautiful, Scree.
Rather more to your taste than Solum, eh?
You said it. Just caught the sunset, too. Wow.
The skies are always golden here.
Okay, okay. We'll write the brochure later. We're on business.
Precisely. Come on, then. Let's head for the water.
As in us in the water?
Naturally.
One thing you should know, Scree. The girl can't swim.
You can't swim?
Oh. And you can, I suppose, a great hunk of rock?
I don't need to swim. Why go to all that trouble? I just sink to the bottom and walk.
This I must see.
Aquis is a water-filled realm, Jen. I was rather hoping... Well, I thought you mortals were...
Yeah, well, the city I'm from isn't a water-filled realm, okay? Of course, most parents took the trouble to get their kids out swimming. Some even went horse riding, too. Girl Scouts, tap classes. With me, you get none of that extracurricular crap, okay?
Sorry.
What is that sound?
I'm not sure, but I believe it's coming from the middle of the lagoon, wouldn't you say?
Guess so.
You know, the Undyne are a very cultured race, aquatic creatures, intelligent. Great allies to Arella.
Like you say, intelligent.
And I gather they're extremely resourceful. Aquis isn't naturally the easiest place for them to survive. You may have guessed. I'm not a total expert on this realm, so maybe I should do a little exploring and report back.
Sure. I'll just settle down here and take in some rays. Good luck, Rocky. Sink and walk. Wait till they get that in the Olympics.
Oh!
Please, please forgive my rudeness, Highness. I did not think a queen would be here, Highness.
I decided that I be placed in this machine to appease the Leviathans, the gods of the sea.
That's terrible.
It is an honor. What greater way to serve my people?
This was your choice?
It was King Adaro's decree. My husband was one of the first to fall to the plague. I am prepared for my fate, Scree.
Forgive my impertinence, but it is superstitious nonsense to suppose that your death could remedy a disease. Surely your realm would be better served by discovering the source. Is there some contagion, something tainting the water, perhaps?
Unlikely. The water in our lagoons is filtered through vast machines.
I can't let you die like this. Let me try to free you. Please let my companion and I try to get to the bottom of all this. Ah, one thing, Your Majesty. My companion is ill-equipped for life in your world. I had to leave her on the surface.
One of the dry ones.
Yes, a mortal. You know how fussy they are about breathing.
Put your hand to the glass, Scree. Pass this gift on to your friend. Warn her to seek out water before adopting our form.
Thank you, Aino. I will return. Jen?
Oh, you're back. I'd throw you a towel, but... So, how'd it go, Rockster?
I think I know what's going on here. And there's someone I want you to meet.
What's with the arm?
Oh, yes. Well, before you meet her, I've brought you back a gift.
A present?
Yes. Yes. It's a surprise.
Damn right it is. So, what is it? Show me.
No, I say we do this properly. Jen, a gift is a gift, after all.
Are you all right, Scree? You sure you've not got that deep-sea whatcha-call-it ringing-in-the-ear stuff?
No, I'm fine. So, close your eyes, hold out your hands.
You are kidding.
Now, don't spoil the fun. Come on.
Unbelievable. You're a grown-up rock now, remember. All right. Go on.
Jen, sorry. I really... There was no other way. I didn't think you'd want to after the last time. And I mean, you've always wanted to swim, yes? I'm so stupid. What's wrong with me today? Jen, dive into the water! You're supposed to be in the water before you transform! Quickly!
Oh, Scree, you really are the most pathetic, stupid, selfish lump of granite I have ever... Ugh!
I heard that.
What?
The Undyne communicate through telepathy. Breathing's no problem either. And I don't know if you've noticed, but you're swimming.
I don't know if you've noticed, but you are in the doghouse.
Hate me later. Right now, I think we may have a problem. Queen Aino, she's dying!
Help me. Help me. We have got to get that contraption down somehow. Scree!
The cage must be operated by a separate mechanism. There was nothing in the tower itself. I pray we're not too late.
It's not too late as long as she's alive.
Thank you.
You okay?
I am alive.
Well, that falls into the okay category. Your Majesty, I've never seen anyone as strong as you. You just wouldn't give up.
I knew suddenly. It wasn't right to be dying in that way.
I've got to say, Your Majesty.
Aina.
Thanks. No, I gotta tell you, I have to tell you. I have never seen my little friend ever get like that. I mean, when you were in trouble there, he was going crazy. You must have made quite an impression.
I'm listening, Jen. Be careful what you say.
This telepathy can really suck.
Queen Aino, it's true that I am more than content to know you are safe again.
You see? For him, that's positively gushing.
I will never be able to thank you adequately for what you have done. Your resourcefulness, simply your goodness. I shan't forget. Now, I am queen of this realm, and have been deprived of seeing my beloved Aquas for far too long. Will you swim with me, Jen?
You try and stop me. This swimming, it could catch on. Aino, okay?
I sense danger, Jen. This is what we Undyne have always dreaded.
What is it?
I must go no further. The waters ahead are tainted. I can sense it. As your friend wisely surmised, there is a contagion.
It's polluted through there?
The Undyne have worked miracles to survive through time. The waters of Aquas are naturally poisonous to our race, but our lagoons and bay are protected, purified by our filtering machines. Without that system, the Undyne are doomed. The plague that has befallen us. I didn't dream it was possible. Could be due to the system's failure. And if we listen, the machines are silent.
Aino, return to the other side of the lagoon. We need you in the very safest water. Arella warned us that there was something terrible going on. That's why we're here. I'll get those purifying machines switched on.
That will be no easy task, I assure you. You must take care, Jen. But the Undyne are now in no position to refuse your help. You have our thanks. Begin at the priming station. That would be the first stage to restarting our system. And for that, we need to get you into the bay. Two of my kind are required to open this door. Goodbye, Jen. And please be careful. Adaro will be through there. My husband was first to succumb to the madness that the plague has wrought upon our people.
Okay. And you stay safe, too. I'll kickstart that motor of yours before you know it. You thinking what I'm thinking?
We've just met King Adaro?
Right. Lewis's drummer gets like that after his fifth shot of Jack.
The poor Undyne Adaro was attacking must have been dead for days.
Well, if he does that to him, just think what he'd be like with us.
I suggest we hurry up and get these waters purified. But I doubt we've seen the last of King Adaro.
Okay. We've got to get this thing going right now. See how that stuff was spreading?
I'll check the master switch and get ready to turn it on. Something wrong? Who are you?
I am Arturo, substation engineer.
Let's get him out of there.
What happened?
A terrible demon came here. Began attacking us. Killed everyone else. He disabled our equipment. Doomed my people. I was able to escape and hide here, but now I'm trapped. Soon, I will join my brothers. All my days, I've never known the turbines silent. The water is very bad, bro. You must get the pumps working.
There must be some way out.
Believe me, I am no hero. There is no choice. At least now, I will hear those turbines one last time. Know that my race will survive.
Your queen would be proud of you.
What are you doing?
I'm going to get the pumps working.
And what about him?
There is nothing we can do. And we have no time. The water is poisoning the population as we speak.
So you're just gonna kill him?
Jen, he knows the sacrifice he's making. We're talking about an entire race, Jen, and probably all of Oblivion. You can't put all that at risk for one Undyne.
You just watch me.
We have no choice.
I said no, Scree. We are not turning this thing on until he is out of there. Now you can either keep arguing, which is pointless, or you can help me figure out how to get him out of there.
Or I could just step past and turn on the switch. So, how do we get him out?
That's my Rocky.
Well?
I'm working on it.
Thank you, my friends.
Nearly there now, Jen. The main controls will be at the top of this tower.
Cool.
Doubtless such an important switch will require some sort of key. Well, we'll soon find out.
You say key? You realize, Rocky, we've just got ourselves locked in here.
Oh, never mind for now. Our first priority is to get the machinery going.
And straight in at the top, a brand new number one priority.
I think that's it.
That's it, Rocky boy, we've done it.
Oh yes, the motors working will be music to Aino's ears.
Don't think we Undyne have ears.
Soon the waters will be pure again, and Undyne life will return to normal.
For the survivors it will. But we haven't seen too many of them.
Jen? Scree. There are more survivors than you imagine. You can hear a signal to my people telling them it is safe to return to the lagoon. Many had fled to secret waters, which are full of different perils. Not all will have escaped those dangers, but most will return safely.
That's great, Aino. Really great. I'm only sorry your husband had to... that he had to die for all this to come right. I'm sorry.
He died long ago, when the affliction first came on. It wasn't my Adaro that you killed. All you should feel now is pride. We have everything to thank you for.
It has been an honor.
I hope you may return to our kingdom one day.
I'd like that. Goodbye, Queen Aino.
Jennifer, Scree, you have both done much to commend yourselves.
Hey, no problem.
Thank you.
Do you believe me now, Jennifer? That Abaddon is a danger to these realms, and that he and his agents must certainly be stopped.
Oh, he's bad news, Aurel. I see that. But it's cool. He tried to mess up Solum and Aquas, and me and the big guy here just cruised on in and made things right. You know, and a problem.
I wish it were that easy, Jennifer. But there are more far-reaching repercussions of these disturbances. Each of these imbalances allow the armies of Chaos to grow and spread.
Oh, here we go.
You are far from the end of your journey, Jennifer.
No, 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 no! I can't keep bailing you guys out, okay? I got my own priorities. I need to find Lewis and get back home. Look, I've helped you plenty now, Aurella, and I don't mind because I like you, but for me, this is the end of the line.
Jen, I'm sure that...
Hold on, mister, because I'm talking to you too. And I mean back there. Yeah, okay. I know you did the right thing in the end, but without me, you were gonna put that guy through the blender. Victory at all costs. And then shouting at me not being ready to make sacrifices. Well, I'm telling you, I've made enough.
No, Jen, no, that's not what I was saying. It wasn't about you.
And while I'm at it, Aurella, don't you think, as the so-called leader of the Forces of Order, that you've been just a little bit negligent? Or was it part of your plan that the fate of the world end up in the hands of an overgrown garden gnome and a goddamn waitress?
Jennifer, Scree deserves better than to be talked to like that.
Whatever. I've had it.
What do you know about your parents, Jennifer?
What?
You never knew them, did you?
How do you know that?
You are a hybrid, Jennifer. Half mortal, half demon. One of only two in all existence. And to me, that makes you more important than an army of demons. Did you think it was just those trinkets on your arms that allowed you to change form? You have powers even Abaddon does not fully comprehend. You can go anywhere. Do things that Belazor could not if he had a millennium. The laws of the Nexus are yours to break. And Lewis is the same.
You're lying.
I had an army once, Jennifer. Just after you were born, I lost it all in a battle to wrest two infants away from Abaddon. Only my general, bravest and strongest of my warriors, escaped the slaughter. And he fled the battlefield to hide you and Lewis in Mortalis. He was captured on his return, and Abaddon gave him to his warlord Belazor so that they might learn of your location. He endured monstrous torments at their hands, but he never spoke a single word as to your whereabouts. Eventually, after many years of torture, he was able to disguise himself and make his escape. To this day, he is believed by our enemies to be dead. Through sheer force of will, he had projected his spirit into the nearby form of a small stone effigy.
Scree. Why didn't he say something?
It is not his way. Do you see now why you must go on?
I'm scared, Aurella.
You must not be. This is your destiny, Jennifer. Are you willing to continue?
I guess so.
Scree?
Ladyship.
Loyal Abdazur, guide Jennifer on into the realm of Aether. Abaddon has bestowed a dark gift upon its people.
But, only if you're not sick of the sight of me.
It would be an honor.
This makes me glad, but hurry. I may not have a presence in the Nexus by the time you return. Go now.
don't like it. Let's go back to the beach.
This is Ethogen, a realm of treacherous mountains and even more treacherous people, the Wraith.
And it's aligned with chaos, right?
In Solum and Aquis, Abaddon was trying to overturn the natural balance. But chaos was already drawing power from here. Doubtless, Abaddon's plan for Aether has simply been to tighten his evil grip.
Just a wild stab in the dark, but I'm presuming these Wraith aren't exactly going to be our bosom buddies.
We will have to be extremely careful here, Jen. But there are two castes in Aether. Up there live the Wraith aristocracy. We must really beware of them. They are decadent and dangerous, true enemies of my Lady Arella. However, the Helot, living in the village over there, are rather different. They live in squalor, oppressed by their rulers. I think they're too downtrodden to pose us any threat. At least that's how things have always been. But as we've seen, none of the realms are as they were.
Ah, don't sweat it, Rocky. We're on a roll. So, where to?
We should make our way out of here and round to the village.
Those dinky little legs finally giving up on you, Scree? I mean, that's a lot of granite to be hauling.
I shall rise above the personal insults and...
Nice to have something you do rise above, Rocky, my boy.
And simply caution you to slow down. I don't like the sound of this place.
Okay. Sorry. I don't hear anything.
Exactly. This village, this square, should be bustling right now. Aether's a tough world to live in. The Wraith peasantry usually pack this place, scraping some way to survive. Why is it deserted?
It's not.
I don't like this at all.
Now, when you're sounding scared, I know this is bad. Why can't we just once stumble upon a fairground, a birthday party, just once?
Get back. Hide now, Jen. Someone's coming.
Uh-oh. We got company.
Keep well hidden, Jen. This isn't going to be pleasant.
A circus, an ice rink, picnic in the park, just once.
But my dearest beauty, can't you simply smell their presence? Cowering, pathetic, filthy.
Awaiting a glimpse of their masters, to drool as we take up their sacrifice, the vermin.
My lord, I have such pleasures awaiting you when we are clear of this nauseous place.
The pleasure will be all yours, Ampusa, my deadly flower. So, let us to the business in hand.
Ungrateful, ignorant race of rats! You think that is worthy? But, as you know, a strong, worthy offering, a young, powerful man, or an athletic woman full of vigor. And what do we get? The rant of your pathetic litter! Now, before this infested pit causes my divine Ampusa to vomit, we shall leave you to select your village's true sacrifice. Captain Valir, I will return shortly to collect the replacement. And never make this mistake again.
My lord,
Come and see the look of sheer relief on this weary old man's face. Now that he has been spared. What a joy.
Ah, so thankful and pathetic. It's his lucky day.
Are you sure, my love, that you don't want me to pluck out an eyeball? At all, for our little Elizabeth.
No, no, my beloved. Leave his eyeballs. Just cut his throat.
Lisez as Angel di utver dot nijana ibilap. Ap kapat.
Scree. That was awful.
I'm sorry you had to see that, my child. Aether always was a perilous place. Now it's chaos at its worst.
You know that pair?
Count and Countess Raum and Ambusa. The Wraith aristocracy have always been evil, living in decadence while the Helots starve. But this is all new. Blood sacrifices.
You see the way he moved?
Time-shifting, Wraith specialty.
Along with good looks and charm. I can't watch and let them get away with that.
First, we need to know exactly what is going on.
There's someone who might know. Shall we follow him?
It's okay. You're perfectly safe. We're not here to hurt you, we...
Get away from there! Follow me, did you?
We saw exactly what you saw in the square. We're here to help.
Then close that trapdoor now, fool! Or you'll help these people to be slaughtered.
Sorry for... But we are going to help you out of this.
Duly and keen. Abhup Lirag.
Look, we're sorry. Scree here was just trying to...
What right have you to talk to me? I will not speak with a corruption now. What are you doing here?
And this is their good guy.
You will talk to me, sir, and you will talk to my friend. You're in no position to turn away allies, believe me.
You expect me to welcome strangers? Her kind brought this upon us.
Listen, I need you to tell me what these sacrifices are all about.
Blood. Count Raum has been gifted with a dark science. He draws blood from my kinsmen to boost his own vitality. When the bell tolls, they take a sacrifice from our village, and they drink his blood.
Vampires.
And so we live in hiding, plagued by beasts unleashed on the village, haunted by the loss of our people, by the approaching toll of the bell. Even haunted by the one aristocrat who tried to help us.
I don't understand.
A duke. Opposed to the Count's godless ways, plotted secretly to help us. But he was finally unmasked and hanged. His bones forbidden our burial rites. The Count has turned his enemy into a phantom. Now, I must prepare for Valyra's return. But I will never again ask one of my brethren to step forward. The next blood shed will be mine.
If we can help it, the last sacrifice has already happened. We'll leave you to talk to your people in peace. I think we need to go to the heart of all this, the Count's mansion. You must do nothing until we return.
Being watched. this place, Scree, I'll give you that. But ghosts? Vampires?
You see up there, Jen? It says, lay me to rest. What do you think, Jen?
We keep going?
That's my girl.
Got the sword now. And the way my vampires glowed when she came near. We need that sword to give me the Wraith Mojo. It's the only way I'll be of any use here.
Remember who we're dealing with, though. None of the Wraith are to be trusted.
Perhaps this gentleman should be given the benefit of the doubt. I think we ought to give the Duke here a proper burial.
Cut it down now!
What? Don't come down now! Just lower it gently after three! One!
Scree! Sorry! Sorry.
I said lower it gently after three.
And I said stand clear. Anyway, no harm.
You've chipped my ear off.
I can't believe it. You've chipped my left ear off.
Oh, dear.
I've been vandalized. It's not funny. It's an ear.
I know. Can't you still hear okay?
What?
Oh, dear. I said, can...
Yes, I heard you.
Sorry. I said, sorry.
It's a whole ear!
It was an accident! I'll keep hold of this. We may be able to stick it back on.
I look ridiculous. There isn't much of me to begin with. Holy ear! I'm lopsided.
We just drop him in, do you think?
No. I'm going to lower him in gently. One, two, three.
Fine. So now we need a sword to go in there, too.
We do. But Wraith burials also require blessed water.
Okay. Perhaps old Pugface can help us with that.
Old Pug? Oh, yes, the gentleman in the cellar.
Hello? It's only us!
We need your help.
I have to do my duty now. Offer myself for sacrifice.
Hey, good plan.
Jen!
No, we won't let them guzzle your blood.
See, if you're there as bait for Rom's captain, we'll be hiding. Take her by surprise. We need to get the Phantom's sword back. It's the only way I'll be able to defeat Rom and have a chance at saving your people.
But first, we've got to give the Duke a proper burial. I believe we'll need blessed water for that.
I see. As we've no other hope, I shall cooperate. I'll sanctify the water, and then place myself for sacrifice. Follow me to the well.
Kehi du kalari, vol eos ac juan anal. Vid biag it vid umov, von san schurur, di due di haide napuni, oto odmok judo. We'll draw no water with this, it's completely broken. If someone were able to climb down there, this is all we would need feed. Someone small.
All right, I'm going. How far down is the water?
Oh, it's a long way down. A long way down.
Naturally.
With what I am to face, this is insignificant.
I told you you're not going anywhere. You're just luring them in for our attack. Don't worry about it. Trust us.
Huh. You had better withdraw.
On San Pipre!
Hold
it, Xena. Man, don't you people have dentists? Now that's the sword I'd kill for. Should have just given me this, honey. Would have saved you a lot of trouble. Oh, great. And I promised the miserable creep I wouldn't let them hurt him.
You fought well, Jen. I should have been more alert. Anyway, it's happened. So I suggest we get on with the burial, now we have the sword. You need the Wraith aspect, and we may even defeat Raum before our friend is sacrificed.
Try and save him, huh? I guess that's the least a corruption like me can do. This should be cool.
Jennifer, a little respect, please.
Hey, Rocky. Tie me from a standing start.
Come on! We haven't got time for this. Only use the Wraith form in emergencies.
It really doesn't bring out the best in you.
What's in there, Scree?
That's the torture chamber, I'd say. Last place we want to find ourselves.
I don't know. Sounds like the place to be.
Let's check it out. Ew, nasty. But it's weird. There's nobody here.
Ooh, listen to her. You lose your head and you're nobody all of a sudden.
You are nobody, you skewered-head fop.
Oh, better a fop than be born in a sewer.
Ah, we're all equal now, though, aren't we, your ladyship?
You reek, Assie. You reek.
If your lot hadn't ripped my arms off, I'd fill that big mouth of yours with a fist.
Quiet, everyone. Quiet. Why are you here?
Guards! Guards, intruders! We have intruders in here!
You bastard!
Now they'll end up like us, you idiot.
Oh, that was fantastic. You killed him.
He was one of the worst. Used to love the rack, didn't he?
Oh, yes. With him, it was always rack, rack, rackety rack.
She says, thanks. He cut her tongue out. Vicious bastard. You'd better hurry. Get away while you can.
Hey, guys. Listen, do any of you know anything about the blood sacrifices? Where that happens?
Nobody say a word. These are traitors.
Will you be quiet, fop?
They've cut your head off, Monsignor, remember? We're not on the Count's side anymore.
None of us were blood sacrifices. They're kept elsewhere.
I do know Count Raum has a machine somewhere in the chateau. It turns Elot blood into a sort of elixir. It told me he could never be defeated unless that machine were destroyed.
And then he chopped your head off, ha!
It was the Countess that removed my topmost point. Dang brats.
Mother.
You were not dancing, Elotface.
You were spinning around like a fat little pig. Why?
I like to dance.
And I like to thrash and bite you, but I don't do it in the ballroom.
You did last week.
Don't answer back! Go to your room before I tell your father.
No, don't tell him! Please don't tell him!
Ah, stop sniveling! You're not a helot!
I hate you!
Well, you're a good little wraith then, at least.
I wish you were dead!
Of course you do. That's my girl. We've brought you up properly. Now get to your home!
Please, Mother. Please, can I come to the ball tonight, please?
No.
Why not?
Because you are unsightly. Everybody hates you, you cannot dance, and I wish you had never been born.
I can dance! I can dance! I hate you! I hate everything!
Honestly, children...
Jen! Jen, is that you?
Hey, Rocky. Am I glad to see you?
Are you okay?
You ever flown coach?
But he hasn't harmed you?
Apart from locking me in a box full of spikes and blades where the slightest movement draws blood, no, he's been the perfect host.
Right, okay. Try to keep still.
Hey, thanks, Scree. I hadn't thought of that.
Sorry. Did he... I mean... He brought you straight up here, did he? He hasn't
touched me, Scree. I think he was saving me for later, but thanks for the concern. No, he suddenly got carried away about my vambrace. He took him away. Locked me up in there. Okay. Now I'm gonna get those vambrace and kick the crap out of him.
Slowly now, Jen.
See if he's still smooth-talking with one of those spikes stuck up his...
Aether is a bad place, Jen. You'll have your revenge. He may be a vampire, sadist, and mass murderer, but he's also quite a scientist by the look of things.
Oh, well, let's just shake him by the hand and swap journals, shall we?
I'm just saying. Locked.
Yeah, I saw him lock it.
We must get this open. But if Raum still has the key on him, we're in trouble.
The boy's a real fashion victim. Hey, I bet one of those severed heads was a tailor that gave him the wrong shade of black. The key's not gonna be in her dresses, Rockhead.
No, I fear he still has it on him. But I think I may have a plan. Tonight, Raum and Empusa are hosting a ball. A masked ball.
Yeah? Whoopee.
If only we could find a way to get one of us close to him. Distract him a little. Steal the key. You know, the kind of distraction and close contact one would find with, say... dancing? Just to pluck an example from thin air?
You can stop plucking. I'm not doing it.
Doing what?
Putting that dress on, disguising myself as a wraith, dancing with the Count, and stealing the key!
Now there's a plan!
I said no! If it's such a good plan, why don't you wear the dress and try it?
Naturally, if you're not capable of carrying off the role of a fine wraith lady, the plan isn't worth pursuing. So, do you have a better suggestion?
Give me that. I'll show him who's a fine wraith lady.
Should be quite a night. I heard one, young lady desperately trying to be invited.
Exclusive guest list, huh? I'll say I'm with the band. Man, is this tight!
I believe that item is worn the other way up.
Oh. Just couldn't resist a peek, huh?
Of
course, there is a certain arcane etiquette at these affairs, a modicum of decorum, naturally, and established codes of behavior that...
What, you don't think I can act like a lady? Well, alrighty.
Don't wait up.
Okay, I'm just the same as them. I am just the same as them. No one will turn a hair. I am just another guest.
Lady, forgive me for intruding. May I have the pleasure? Rarely have I seen someone dance with such poise and grace.
Why, thank you, Count Rome. You're quite a mover yourself.
Thank you. But you appear to have me at a disadvantage. Might I inquire as to your name?
Why, surely a lady should be allowed a certain mystique?
Since I'm well acquainted with my other guests, I assume you must be the Duchess Natalia. From the Eastern Province.
Oh. How clever of you to guess that. Because that is my name, Duchess Natalie.
Natalia.
Natalia.
You know, Duchess, it is strange, but I had heard rumors that you were the size of a prize bull.
I've been ill. Curiously enough, I heard you were the size of a prize bull, too.
My dear nimble Duchess.
Well, sir, I wouldn't want you to neglect your wife. I'm a great admirer of the Countess, and I must go now to... powder my nose. Have I stolen the key to your heart, I wonder?
I am a heartless nobleman. Have you not heard? Perhaps we can enjoy a rather more intimate dance later.
I must go now. Before I blow my lunch on your tuxedo. Come on, Scree. I've got it.
Who were you talking to, Rama?
Oh, just a tiresome guest, my poisonous orchid. Oh, these affairs are full of parasites and balls.
Oh, must we wait until the end of the evening to drink the hallowed blood?
There is nothing we must do, Empusa, my beloved. We answer to no one.
No. We can wait. Let us enjoy the anticipation. A pleasure to savor when the guests are gone.
Shall we dare?
Thank you.
Rao must have been especially intrigued by the Vambrace, testing the potential of an unfamiliar application. A curiosity as to hybrid capacity for potency is natural enough, and a controlled experiment would enhance...
Professor Skryovsky, how about experimenting with silence?
Elizabeth? Hello, Elizabeth.
Hello, Elizabeth. How are you?
Hey, that's a lovely little pet you've got there. Does he have a name?
Yes. Claude.
Well, you've certainly got him nice and tame. Claude keeps very still.
Of course it's very still. It's dead.
Well, you mustn't be too sad. I'm sure you were a very kind...
Why would I be sad? I killed it.
Think of the savings on pet food, huh, Lizzie?
Elizabeth.
Elizabeth. That's right. Well, I'm Jen, and this is Scree.
I saw you dancing with my father.
I know, I saw you seeing me. See?
And Elizabeth, I saw you dancing in the ballroom earlier. I thought you were wonderful.
I can't dance. I'm useless. I hate dancing.
Well, you know, I don't think any of that's true, young lady. You love dancing, and you were great.
Are you going to kill my father?
Elizabeth, what we really need, what we'd like to ask... You've got a key to the maze, haven't you? Can we borrow it?
Ugh, stupid maze. I hate it. It's boring.
Can we have the key?
Only if you're going to kill my father. You are, aren't you?
I may be... having a fight with him, yes.
Kill him, then. Please kill him. I bet you can't.
Oh, we'll see.
And my mother?
We'll see, honey.
No. You can only have it if Scream... dances with me. I want to dance with Scream!
Oh, I see. No, it's Scree.
Oh.
But, no. Yes, of course. Excellent. It will be my pleasure.
Come on, then. And ask properly or no key.
Excuse me, miss. May I have the pleasure of this dance?
You may.
Thank you, Miss Elizabeth.
I've never been allowed to dance before.
When you've killed my mother and father, can I keep Mr. Scree as a pet?
I wouldn't kill him, I promise.
Well, you see, I sort of need him. Sorry, Elizabeth.
I want him! I hate you! You're so selfish!
But later I'm going to insist on another dance, Elizabeth. And you'd better not say no.
All right.
Guess the old fangs in the neck trick went out of fashion. So, we're looking to do a bit of industrial sabotage here. But I'm pretty light on Semtex right now. So, what's the plan?
Just give me a moment. Now, how does this contraption work?
I know how it works.
You see, Jen, our friend there is still alive.
Expect they thought he was just too nice a guy to go into the blender.
I'm so glad we've got to you in time. There.
You're welcome.
Sir, did they put you into the device?
No. The Count forced me to watch as he drained the lifeblood from my brethren.
Well, there will be no more sacrifices. We're here to destroy the machine.
No. Forget the machine. And consider those chalices. They are already filled with the Count and Countess's draft for this evening. Later, the guard will collect them. Contaminate the contents. And that godless pair would no longer be invincible.
Some sort of poison, do you think?
They are immune to such trifling notions. You are dealing with race, imbecile.
So what do you suggest?
I suggest you, corruption. I suggest you. Hybrid blood will contain the mortal taint. That, mixed with the race element already drawn here, would prove highly dangerous to them. You must enter the machine.
Sounds like a reasonable plan.
What?
Okay, time out here.
The corruption would like a tiny word in Coach's ear.
What, Jen? I only said it sounded reasonable, that's all.
Stop. Okay, you expect me to strap myself into a machine built with only one purpose. To kill, and to leave that fruitcake at the controls.
I merely expressed an opinion.
You trust him with my life?
No, but if you do it, Jen, I won't let him harm you. So, do you trust me? Okay now, gently does it. Fine, I think we've got enough. You can stop it now. I said stop it! Are you mad? You're killing her!
Give me that! There is nothing you can do to stop this, runt.
Two lovebirds enjoying a cozy little nightcap.
The party's over, guys.
Why didn't I simply disembowel you straight away, Hybrid? You see what happens when one ignores one's instincts.
But then you would have missed drooling over that prize bull, Natalia. Maybe now we can have that other little tango you promised.
You don't imagine I was being serious. Of course I recognized you.
Yeah, right.
Leave this grand city default to me. I'm just easy kill.
Yo, Countess. Somehow hope you'd be first.
You've killed her.
Not such a fan of slaughter when it's your own little bunnykins, huh?
But she shouldn't be. She'd only just drunk from...
Oh, yeah, that's right. You thought your cool isotonic cocktail would have protected her.
Big mistake.
But it works. We experimented.
Now, I'm confused. Are you weeping as a husband or a scientist?
Wraith noblemen do not weep. Swift vengeance is far more our style.
Can't hear you, Realm. You trying to say how sorry you are? Want to donate your body to science?
I'm dying.
Yeah, that's right, baby. I made my own little deposit into your blood bank.
I'm dying quickly. Oh, damn you, hybrid. I was hoping I'd really suffer at the end.
He'll be sadly missed.
Elizabeth? Elizabeth? Come on, Jen. This battle's over. At least the Helot can come out of that cellar now and not fear for their lives. It's time for us to leave Aether.
I won't be rushing back.
I'm proud of you, Jen.
Whoa, where are we?
We are back in the Nexus, Jen. My Lady Arella has gone, it seems. Abaddon holds sway here. Come on, we have to get to Kronos. He must be protected.
Scree? Scree, where are you?
I'm right here. Keep going.
Scree!
Jen! Keep going!
Turn around.
Why? Why, Lewis? Every second since I've got to this godforsaken place, I've been praying I'd see you soon. And now I can't bring myself to look at you.
What's happened to you? Lewis! Lewis, speak to me, goddammit! Lewis... You can hear me, can't you?
A love lost. How careless. And you are lost. Hybrids belong nowhere.
What have you done to Lewis?
Do you know who I am?
You're Abaddon, Lord of Chaos, and a complete jerk. I mean, believe me, I've never been like Little Miss Establishment, but what you are isn't chaos. It's greed. It's evil. You're just destroying everything.
Arella's lies are killing you. You have failed. Arella. Arena, where is your guardian now?
It's okay. Come on, Jen.
I was too late, Scree. It was Lewis. He tore the heart out of Cronus. Killed him. It was awful. I don't know what's happened. He isn't Lewis anymore.
Okay. Shh.
It's all over, Scree. It's all over. Abaddon's won.
Now, my girl, stop that. Right. The best thing to do when things get as bad as this is to look at the facts. Agreed? Good. Fact number one. And top fact on the list. I am still alive. Agreed? Good. Fact number two. You're still here to take care of me. Thank goodness for facts.
It was horrible. Abaddon's everywhere.
But he hasn't won yet, Jen. Believe me, we have one last hope. Now, you're not going to let him get away with all this, are you? What he's done to Lewis?
No. I'm gonna kick his ass.
That's the spirit.
So, what's this last hope, Rocky?
The last hope. The last slim hope. The last...
All right. A long shot. I got it.
Lies in the realm of Volca.
Shouldn't we save our post-match analysis till we're out of here?
Of course. I think I'm simply trying to prepare you.
Not a big fan of this place, are you, Rocky?
None of my lady's followers would ever choose to be in Volca. But when I was last here, I was bound, hooded, rarely conscious, and tortured relentlessly.
Yeah, we got clubs like that back home. Sorry.
So, nice to be back.
What are we doing here, then?
I think it's our last chance. It is a formidable realm, the very essence of chaos. Abaddon won't have needed to lift a finger in Volca. And yet supreme strength lies here as well. The rulers of its cruel race, the Djinn, have terrible godlike powers. Secrets which could be critical now that Cronus is lost to us.
You know, this is some mountain.
It's a volcano.
Good.
And we're going in.
Better still.
The Djinn are a ferocious race, Jen, and they live in tune with this volcano. While it's dormant, they're at their weakest, but their power builds up as the volcano heads towards eruption. And when this thing goes up, we better be long gone.
Can't see a thing. Oh, listen to that echo.
Yes, the chamber is of considerable size. The royal court resides here during the years of dormancy, awaiting the shift in the geothermal cycle that heralds the next active.
Hello, Volca!
What are you doing?
Checking out the echo.
The Djinn are a volatile, capricious people, Jed. They have almost limitless power, and they answer to no one. Can we try not to upset?
You said they were dormant until the shift in the geothermal doohickey.
The geothermal cycle may be influenced by the simplest actions on our part, or even just our very presence here. We have to be extremely cautious.
Okay. Why is it so dark in here?
Well, they don't need light, Jen, not during the dormancy.
Yeah, well, I do. Give me that. Don't worry, one little lamp's not gonna...
Quick and Gwen, who has dared disturb us while the mountain sleeps? I only hope you have not woken mighty King Iblis himself. Who are you?
Apologies, my lord. Keep quiet. If they learn that we are on the side of order, we are as good as dead. I am a servant of Abaddon, Lord of Chaos, and am here on my master's behalf.
Is that so?
My Lord Abaddon considers King Iblis to be an invaluable ally. He holds your king in the highest esteem.
The king has no love for any of those from the Nexus, including your Lord of Chaos, I believe. But then, the king is not necessarily altogether wise, is he? A stranger, for example, arriving with harmful intent towards the king, might be welcomed by some. The stranger would only have to let it be known, and he might find friends in the court, a way of reaching the ear of the queen, even. A more deserving sovereign, some would say. Well... But I see you have a hybrid, a rare jewel indeed. I am told they have many unique powers.
Oh yes, oh yes.
Scree.
I should like a hybrid of my own. You will sell me this one, eh?
I would be doing you a disservice, sir. That hybrid is very lazy and none too bright.
No? It looks acceptable.
Oh, I know my hybrids. I could bring you a better one another time, but this one is lame, a burden to be seen with. Aren't you? You see, feeble-minded.
If I were you, I would beat some sense into it.
Oh, I shall. Later.
Not for sale. As you wish. But she will be of little use to you here, not in her current form. A small gift to help you on your way.
Folks just say it with flowers.
I trust your stay in our kingdom will be illuminating.
It was close. Are you all right?
Sure. Except I'm a burden to be with, apparently.
Well, of course not. I had to say something.
Enough! You have proved yourself a savage and brutal fighter, Hybrid. I am glad you are fighting for me rather than against, as was this fool's intention.
What's that supposed to mean?
Silence! The Hybrid is mine now. This one still lives, Hybrid. Cast him into the pit.
Which just shows how little you know her. Jen? What are you doing?
Out of the way.
Jen, look at me. What have you done to her?
The gift I bestowed binds her to me. She no longer knows you.
No! Will hear of this, and he'll hear of your scheming, the way you tried to enlist us in some plot to overthrow him.
The king? You fool! I am the king. I am Iblis.
Innocent, the brave, and the lunatic would dare to rouse Queen Malakel from her rest. Which have I here? Who are you?
Your pardon, lady. I am but a humble envoy of Lord Abaddon. I seek your majesty's guidance in a very delicate matter. I must firstly plead for your intervention. King Iblis has subjugated a companion of mine, a hybrid much prized by my master. A transgression which could prove dangerous to all of us. It is also my grave duty, I feel, to speak boldly, to warn you that your husband suspects your majesty of treachery toward him.
You are lying.
Majesty, it's true. He was in disguise, keen to test our loyalties, said he could reach the ear of the queen if we...
Oh, that. No, of course he suspects me. He is right to. Leaving his impregnable Hall of Gods to hunt for plotters, it's his favorite pastime.
Well, it is also true that he has recklessly captured a hybrid.
Doubtless he has. Advice now. While in Volca, you should aspire to emulate the strength of the djinn, and not our talent for deceit. Why do you lie?
Your Majesty?
You are no envoy of Abaddon. We have played host to Abaddon's henchmen and thugs countless times. You are not one of them.
He's trying a new type of henchman these days.
I have the gift of reading people, their inner thoughts. Be aware of that. Who do you serve?
Abaddon.
You are stubborn at least. Courageous even. And there is something deeper within you that I confess I cannot read. But I shall in time. As for the simpler matter, you serve Arella. If you have come to seek my help, you be wise not to anger me and be plain. What is it you want?
I need to rescue this hybrid girl from your husband.
That is what you want now. Why did you come to Volca?
I have come from the Nexus with the last hope of saving us all. Our guardian, Kronos, has been murdered.
The Timekeeper is dead?
His heart cut out. The work of a hybrid, the orders of Abaddon. The Nexus has fallen to chaos already. It is only a matter of time before all the realms topple, Volca included.
For years I warned Iblis that Abaddon could not be trusted. But he has always been blinded by the Dark One's gift of immortality and a pledge of influence beyond this realm. Now his greed may cost us everything.
He may have been warned of your coming by Abaddon. Intercepted this hybrid for fear of her threat to him.
Iblis always likes to strike first.
If you can help us, Your Majesty, you must.
If our dynasty is teetering on a precipice, allow me to decide what I must do.
Where is your hybrid now?
Still with the king, I imagine. His djinn essence has melded her will to his own.
Hold out your hand. Unlike the essence from Iblis, mine will not consume her mind.
If you elect not to trust me, that is your choice. Now, rescue your hybrid from Iblis's power and return to me. With her, we will stand a chance. If you fail, then we may as well all join the ancient kings and the legendary corpse of Abdizir in the labyrinth beneath Volca. Oblivion would soon be no more.
Thank you, Majesty. Jen?
You. Hey, I'm glad you're still alive. This way I get to kill you myself.
Wait! It's me, Scree! We're allies! We're friends even, remember?
I don't think so.
You must remember me. We came here together.
Why in hell would I come in here?
You're not well, Jen. The Jinn essence passed to you by Iblis has placed you in his thrall.
Well, I have felt kind of trippy lately.
See? You're not yourself at the moment. Let me help you, please. You don't really want to hurt me!
You would help a lot more if you stay still!
Jen, you're making a mistake!
Nice try, Short Stack.
Please. Please don't call me that.
Ooh, you don't like Short Stack, huh?
What's the problem, Half Pint?
Suddenly you're some kind of bonsai badass, huh? Well, come on then, Pee-wee, step up.
Right, young lady. You leave me no option.
Yeah. Bring it on.
Strong as an ox. Let's break Iblis's hold over you. Jen, how are you feeling?
Like I just stepped out of the mosh pit.
I'll assume that's not good.
What happened back there? Man, I was having some weird dreams.
The essence Iblis passed to you made you his pawn.
I lost control. Did I do anything bad?
Well, yes, but no more than I'd expect under the circumstances.
What was I doing? Freaking out? Talking in tongues? Channeling Elvis?
It doesn't matter, Jen. You're back now and that's all that counts.
Come on, Scree. I won't be embarrassed. Was I like some drooling wreck slumped in the corner? Because I have done that a few times on a night out. Oh. Oh my God. I'm remembering. I hate you.
Well, we hit each other. It was six of one, half a dozen of the other.
I called you names. Scree, I am so sorry.
It's in the past now, Jen.
No, really, Scree, your size is simply... It's not an issue for me.
Just drop it, will you?
Okay.
Look, you'd better shift into the Jinn aspect to check Malakel's essence is pure.
Well, let's see.
Must kill Shorty.
Oh, very funny.
Scree, wait up. I was teasing. You know you're a giant in my eyes. Oh, don't be so sensitive.
You need to meet Malakel, the queen.
Can we really trust her?
Probably not. But no matter why she's helping us, I'm afraid we do need her. Your Majesty, I've returned.
That much I can see. Now, this must be your hybrid.
Hi. Occasionally people call me Jen.
Do they?
I hear you might have a solution to our problem.
I think you may be the solution. Long ago, Abaddon needed to guarantee an ally on Volca's throne. So he bestowed immortality on my husband. The gift he gave him was a heart stone that beats eternally in his chest. According to legend, the stone stays the ravages of time and sickness and protects from the hand of both demon and mortal, but not that of a hybrid.
So it's the same type of stone that Lewis pulled out of Cronus?
Exactly. With that stone, the Timekeeper may be revived. You must kill the king and take his heart.
You want us to kill your husband?
And take his heart. That is correct.
So that's your sovereign's secret power. And we can revive Cronus.
And stabilize the Nexus. And the realms would all survive. Yes. And here, I will take the throne.
What do you think, Jen? It's you who's got to do it.
Hell, since everyone else wants him iced, who am I to argue?
It won't be easy. The Djinn are children of fire. Iblis's powers are strongest when the magma rises, and the volcano is already awakening. Now that you are lost to him, he will have retreated to his Hall of Gods. He will be expecting you.
Thank you, Your Majesty. Ready, Jen?
No.
This must be the Djinn Hall of Gods.
That would be a good guess. These statues are huge. You gonna share the joke, Your Majesty? Maybe we can all split our loincloths at the same time.
We should get out more.
I hoped you would be so audacious, but the sight of you actually daring to enter the Hall of Gods is truly ridiculous.
Okay, get ready for the punchline. And try not to wet yourself. Keep a little dignity. I'm here to kill you.
I could sweat the pair of you into this pit of fire with one trifling exertion. But why should a glorious king lift his finger at all? How dare you pursue me to this chamber?
The bigger they come, the harder they fall. Don't you have that phrase around here? Of a grip you got there, friend. I think you're about to fall.
Pull me out of here. Please.
My head says no. My heart says no, too. Bad luck.
No! Melikel, my queen, are you going to allow this pair of treacherous outsiders to murder your husband?
Yes.
Okay, wait up a moment. I'm not under anyone's spell anymore. Why does he have to take this tumble at all? I mean, we got what we need.
Can't we just take the heart and race straight back to Cronus?
Such compassion is rare indeed here in Volca. And you know, it is quite contagious. But not that contagious. Iblis reigned through tyranny and corruption. He deserves no pity. Now, give me the heart.
What do you mean?
It is quite simple. Give me the heart.
What? Why should I?
Do you see any way out of this chamber? I will show you the way. And you will leave with the means to revive Cronus.
Scree. Yeah. Well, don't drop it like you dropped your husband, huh? Jeez! Will you get Madame Butterfingers here?
An immortal queen in Volca at last. With this heart, I shall keep the most treacherous djinn in some sort of... order. Arella would appreciate that.
Your Majesty.
That is all you require, believe me. And this is your way out of the Hall of Gods.
Like she could be trusted. A way out of here, my ass.
At the foot of that precipice, there is a rift gate.
How do you know? You been here before? Scree, we gotta go down, not up.
There is something I must do if we are to have a chance of surviving that descent.
Scree!
I must, Jen!
This may be the last you see of me.
Scree, if it's that dangerous, don't go! What are you doing? Scree! 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 Scree!
Well, here goes.
Guess who needs bailing out again? Oh my God, Scree! Scree! What did you have to smile about, great monk? I won't leave you lopsided, Rocky Boy. I know. You'd hate me wasting time blubbering here. We're on a mission, right? Goodbye, Scree.
I suppose you meant a great deal to me.
More than you could possibly know. So now you want to kill me too, huh? Well, that's just fine, Spikey, because I'm ready to...
That's no way to greet an old friend. One minute you're crying like a baby because you think I've had a fall, next...
Scree!
Of course it's me, and I would prefer Abdazur if you're capable of such a momentous adjustment.
Okay, don't push it, because those tears weren't just for you. I mean, it has been an emotional couple of days. You remember that. Ha! General Abdazur. Wow.
Hold on tight to the djinn heart. It's a long way down, Jed. Run.
My pride, you disappoint me. can hide a broken heart. Life is behind you, yet you stare ahead.
Lewis, I need that thing, Lewis.
Lewis is dead.
Jen.
Lewis.
We pay the landlord some of what we owe the sleazeball leech. But then we carry on the party.
Yes.
That's okay?
Said so, didn't I?
No arguments? No? Are you feeling okay?
I'm just fine. You're back.
Then watch my back. Man, tonight that was some weird. Some weird.
Lewis? Lewis!
Jen! Jen! Hurry, Jen! You must take the heart to Kronos. It may be too late!
He was Lewis.